Extraordinary life demands enthusiasm and the ability to discriminate between what is meaningful and what is meaningless. So in the earlier video part 1, we have discussed on Abhyasa as the first spiritual foundation. If you desire to live an extraordinary life, there are 3 important spiritual foundations you must adhere to. The first is Abhyasa, or practice with enthusiasm. The second is Vairagya, or non-attachment, with serenity. And third, Akam Chitta, that is a calm inner perceptual state. In this video, we shall discuss the other side of the coin, that is non-attachment or Vairagya. Let's remind ourselves that our aim is to develop more self-awareness to enable us to reduce suffering and increase inner peace, which is essential if you aim to achieve anything worthwhile in your life. So to develop this inner peace, Maharshi Patanjali asks us to practice Abhyasa and non-attachment. He does not give us a choice, either Abhyasa or Vairagya. We need a balance of both to be calm, peaceful and joyful. So Maharshi Patanjali in his Yoga Sutra, chapter 1, shloka number 15, he says, Drashta anushravika vishaye vitrashnas vashikar sangya vairagyam. Mastering of detachment or Vairagya occurs when we have no desire or thirst or vitrashnas for objects which we can perceive, that is drashta, and for concepts or objects that we have heard but never experienced, that is anushravika. So when the mind loses desire even for objects whether seen or described in a tradition or in scripture, it acquires a state of utter desirelessness, that is called non-attachment or Vairagya. But non-attachment is the most misunderstood term in common knowledge. We often think non-attachment means giving up our all worldly pleasures, and this thought itself makes us shiver back. Many of us are apprehensive whether non-attachment means giving up the worldly comforts which we are so used to in our daily life. Well, let me explain the broad concept of non-attachment through a story which my guru told me. For example, you have a liking for ice cream, and there is a famous ice cream shop which is a short drive from your home. Now, non-attachment does not prevent you from liking the ice cream as such. But imagine what happens when you drive with your family to the ice cream shop after your dinner and find that the shop is closed. What is your reaction? Do you feel pained or dejected? Then you are attached to your liking. Non-attachment would mean that you would not feel dejected or pained at finding the shop closed. It's a kind of a letting go attitude to all the attractions of life. Are you able to understand the difference? Remember, Maharshi Patanjali has mentioned about Raga and Dveshas as 2 of the 5 kleshas which cause pain and suffering. Raga and Dvesha are 2 sides of the same coin. When you have attachment for anything, and if you do not get it, you develop Dvesha or aversion. So what I am trying to point out through this story is that if your liking for the ice cream results in pain, if you are not able to get it, that is a problem. Liking the ice cream is not the problem. So in this video, we shall go in deep details about the second foundation of Vairagya or non-attachment. So stay all till the end of this video. And if you have not subscribed yet, I suggest you to subscribe to this video and press the bell icon to ensure that you do not miss out on the important videos in this series. But before we start, let us pray to Lord Ganpati for all of us, including you who are watching this video. Om Shri Ganeshaya Namaha. I call upon the lineage of my gurus to bless me. My heartfelt gratitude to my guru for choosing me as a medium to express himself. Om Hrom Nityanandaye Namaha. Om Hrom Shri Shaligram Sharmaye Namaha. Om Hrom Shri Kanayalal Sharmaye Namaha. Om Shri Gurve Namaha. The word Vairagya comes from vi means without and raga means desire or your attachment. So Vairagya therefore means without attachment. So in the second chapter of the sutras, Maharshi Patanjali says that one of the sources of suffering is over-identifying with external objects or ideas or belief systems. The ego consciousness or the asmita has a need to attach or cling to something to feel safe. So whenever we attach to an object or an idea or a belief, it inevitably leads to pain and suffering. The simplest way of describing non-attachment is as the process of letting go. We gradually learn to let go of both our attachments and also aversions, systematically moving deeper into subtler and subtler layers of attachments in the mind. I am reminded of the great philosopher Rumi, who has said, "Life is a balance of holding on and letting go." Balance is the crux of life. Everything in life is in perfect balance and harmony. The night balances the day, the good balances the evil, and so on. Even in the minutest atoms, the very building blocks of the physical universe, you can see there exists a positive charge, that is a proton, that is balanced by a negative charge or electron. So the very act of releasing is powerful. It leads to healing. It helps recharge your energy and put things into perspective. Love is what is left when you let go of all the things you love. However, Maharshi Patanjali is a very tough taskmaster. He takes non-attachment even beyond this. It is not just a practice of letting go, but is a practice of not taking on in the first place. Now, non-attachment is not suppression or repression of your wants or your wishes or your desires or your thoughts or your emotions. It comes by the ongoing practice of awareness of the existence of attachments and gradually letting these weaken. It is very easy to fool ourselves into thinking that I am practicing non-attachment and I have lost my craving to some object, but inside my heart I am longing for it very intensely. non-attachment is cessation. Even if attachment does occur, whether it is attraction or aversion, the real act of non-attachment comes from the cessation of mental clinging, not from an act of diverting your attention away forcefully. We need to see where our mind is attached and then learn to systematically release the colorings of the mind through the yoga practices. One important thing to note here is that here we are talking of non-attachment to not only our longings and attractions, but also to our aversions and the things that we hate. Because both attachment and aversion are again two sides of the same coin. Another important aspect is that non-attachment is not detachment. Detachment implies that there is something which is first attached. There is an attachment first, and then you then apply some method or technique to disconnect that attachment. While non-attachment, on the other hand, means that the connection simply does not exist or does not occur in the first place. Non-attachment is not a case of doing something, but is instead a non-doing kind of a thing. Let me give you an example of two people who stopped smoking many years ago. One of that person is still attached to his cigarettes, and when he sees a cigarette, the craving begins. He tries to resist his desire and then lets go of the desire. This is detachment. But the other person, who has also left smoking, but when he sees a cigarette, there is literally no reaction. The desire has completely disappeared at all levels of his consciousness and even in his unconscious mind. So this is the meaning of non-attachment. The attachment is not released, but is simply not there anymore. Maharshi Patanjali explains that non-attachment deepens to progressively deeper levels of our being. While we may start with our more surface level attachments, such as the objects and our people of the daily life, the practice deepens to include all the objects or experiences we might have only heard about them. So it means that even the real hardcore yogis who are doing yogic practices, either to obtain some supernatural powers, which are called siddhis, or even with a deeper desire of self-realization, are also in some kind of a form, they are attached to some goal. The most important attribute of vairagya happens to be the ability to discriminate between the essential and the non-essential, what is meaningful to us and what is non-meaningful. When we are in this mindset of vairagya coupled with abhyasa, we get into the space between enthusiasm and serenity. It is in this space that we find peace within our inner perceptual space. Here is where awareness of the self can arise. It is within this space of calmness we are able to develop the right thoughts, the right speech, and the right action, which are the essential ingredients to accomplish any goal, either big or small in life. So now, if you have a temptation to subscribe to this video, just wait. As your well-wisher, I want you to first make a promise to yourself that you shall strive to become a better version of yourself each and every single day of your life, starting from today. And now that you have made this promise to yourself, go ahead and click and subscribe. You will be really amazed to see the tremendous power of this ritual, because promises made to the self work very deep inside our subconscious to get us what we desire. I am your brother guide to prosperity, and my mission is to help you realize the dreams of your life and help you achieve something worthwhile in life, for which your family, your parents, and your children can be proud of. We'll see you in my next video.